Hey guys, Andrew here, also known as SlayerRocket86, and today we are going to be talking about Minecraft future updates, either that being 1.5, 1.6, and other updates and stuff. So it's going to be a huge community speaks where you, the viewer, gets to put in your own voice and opinion on what you guys want to see in future updates of Minecraft and Minecraft future stuff in general. So, real quick, if you are here for the latest Minecraft snapshot news and coverage, either being snapshot 13W01, 02, or 03A, hit the annotation in the bottom left hand side of this video. That'll take you to the channel where you guys can see all of the latest Minecraft news, coverage, and up to date stuff. So, made it super simple for you guys. You don't have to search, it's all right there. Number one source for Minecraft news and coverage. So, plain and simple, you can hit the annotation, or you can hit the annotation in the bottom right hand side, which will take you to the latest video. Now, I'm also doing a giveaway for this video. All you guys have to do is leave a comment below, and if you could, leave a like. You guys have been requesting for more of these, and I deliver. So, what you guys wanted me to do in this giveaway was give away anything on the Minecraft Jinx store or a Minecraft code for you guys to. Some of you guys don't have a Minecraft account or a legit Minecraft account, so I will be giving away a gift code so you guys can have your own account or a second account or give it to a buddy or sell it, whatever you guys want. And that includes an Xbox account as well. So, or an Xbox Minecraft Edition code. So, yeah, that's all available. All you guys have to do is leave a comment below, and if you could, leave a like if you want to. If this video gets more than 250 likes, I will go ahead and give two things away to two lucky people in this video. And again, all you guys have to do is leave a comment below, and if you could, like the video. You don't have to, but we would really appreciate it. Also, guys, if you do win, like, again, you gotta keep checking your messages, because I sent two people now messages that haven't responded yet, and I see they're still active on YouTube, so please check your messages if you have won, because if you don't respond within 2 weeks, I'm gonna have to give it to someone else. But on to the video. If you guys don't know what community speaks, it's basically where you, the community, get to basically voice your opinions, and your comments will determine what I talk about and show in the next video. Now, this is a video series I've been doing lately on, I think this is the 6th episode, and this is an amazing mod, of course, that I am using. It is Biomes O' Plenty, I think that's the name of it, and as you guys can see, it is magnificent. These are the redwood pine, or just redwood forest, the giant ones. Now, I already made a video with giant redwood trees, but those actually were just giant pine trees. These ones are giant redwood trees, and they are amazing. Now, I gotta say, in this mod, which is available in the description below, it took me forever to find these. Now, you guys have been requesting me make more of these videos, and again, your comments that you guys leave in this video could be in the next video, as you guys saw in the beginning of this video, I showed them. But yeah, so I want you guys to first answer this one question. What do you think about these woods? Now, the reason why I'm showing you guys these biomes specifically instead of what I usually show you guys, which is amazing maps, is because this is part of an amazing mod which has its own engine. Now, what I say about engine, I mean these things all spawn in the game, kind of like biomes do in regular Minecraft. The only difference is that these biomes are different and they are amazing. Now, this is something that could really be implemented into Minecraft. Now, I want to see, what do you guys think? Because a lot of you guys would like to see these stay as mods. But some of these things, I think, could be just so phenomenal and incredible that would be amazing if they could add to Minecraft. Just like jungles, a lot of people said, things like that should stick as mods, they cost a lot of lag. But again, you don't have to play in those biomes if you don't want to, and so many people love those biomes. So that's what, again, I want to see what you guys think, because I don't like other people that say that's stupid and all that. You know, I don't have my own specific opinion when I make these videos. I try to throw my opinion out there, but I listen to what you guys say. Every comment that I put out there is basically a summary of all the comments that I've been reading, because I do read everyone's comments. That's why I show them in my video now, so you guys can see that I actually do read all your comments. And basically, that's why I really like, you know, making these community speaks, because all the developers of mods and texture packs and even Mojang themselves can see these and see what the community really wants. I think YouTube is the absolute best way of sharing ideas and everything, which is why I make these videos. So tell me, what do you guys think of these? Now, as you guys can see, these are some massive trees. They are what I believe is as tall as a jungle tree. Now, this one looks extremely tall, as you guys can see. It is from regular sea level all the way to almost cloud level, which is 64 blocks. So it is a massive tree. It doesn't have that much leaves on it. Actually, it does have a pretty good amount of leaves compared to a regular tree. But it's got around the same as a jungle tree would. Now, thickness, of course, this is a very, very big tree. Now, technically, this isn't a 2x2, but it's... I don't know what this specifically is. There's a log in the middle, as you guys can see, and then there's four on the outside, which does make it the biggest tree in Minecraft. But then you get down here to the middle part of it, which is a 3x3, which would just make it huge. And then you come down here, which is still a 3x3, but then it's got, again, these four additions to the edges, which make it both amazing and also incredibly large, which I, you know, since Jungles came out, I think that was around January when they came out, or February, I kept saying, I want to see a bigger tree. I know that's what happens when you give people something awesome, they just want more and they want it bigger and better. But honestly, I really do. I wanted a tree. It could be a super rare tree, and I know they have it in Tekkit, because I played Tekkit, and there was a random giant tree in the jungles. I think it was like a rubber tree. There's two types of rubber trees, but this one was like massive, and I loved it because it was so thick that you could actually make your home in it. Kind of like a mushroom, you can make your own home in it. Just think about it, like right in here. Okay, I kind of messed it up by putting that there, but let me bring this down over here. You could put this as your own little cover. You've got a little hut, and then you could of course build your way up, like have a little ladder that takes you to the top, and then over here you could do something that takes you again. You could have some ladders here, and they lead you all the way to the very top, and I think that would just be awesome. I don't know. Again, second question of the day, what do you guys think? Would you like something like that implemented into the game? Yes or no? Tell me why. But look at that, all the way to the very top. And the other really cool thing about this is because these trees are in this form, which I'll show you guys down here, where there is one in the middle and then four in the outside. The awesome thing about that, instead of having to have a 3x3, you could have these four on the outside and you could still have a ladder in the middle. So without the lag that a giant tree would have, that just makes it amazing. And again, since these trees are not a full 3x3 all the way to the top, it's only halfway, that makes it a little bit less lag. And pretty, I don't know, they seem pretty non-crazy lag to me, in my opinion, but I have a pretty good computer, so that might be why. But compared to jungle biomes, these have around the same type of lag. Now, one thing, for all the people out there that are going to say, this is too much lag for Minecraft, keep in mind, Minecraft 1.5 is adding a new rendering system that's going to make everything a lot smoother. It's going to be Mojang's version of Optifine, pretty much, as stated by Mojang and by Datenbone himself. So, with that in mind, there is a whole entire new door that is being opened to new biomes, either being above clouds or just massive jungle trees and forests like this. Now, I have one other biome to show you guys, and let's go on to that. Now, this here biome is actually a pretty crazy one, and what I love about this mod, which I've stated in the previous videos showing this mod and all the community speaks for it, is that in this biome, which is what looks to be a gigantic red clay biome, also a little bit of mud over here. I don't know if this is, I think, yeah, this is a different biome. But as you guys could see, when you come in here, and let me switch from biome so you guys could see the difference. Over here, you look at the sun, it's like a gigantic, oh, actually, I can't even find the sun. Okay, there's the sun, right over there. I think it is rising or setting. It is, rising, actually. So, the whole entire atmosphere changes. Now, we do have this type of thing in Minecraft, but it only applies to three different types of biomes. Winter biomes, and desert biomes, and every other biome is the same. So, winter biomes, if there's weather in it, you get snow. If you go to a regular biome, there's rain, and if you go to a jungle, not jungle, but if you go to a desert biome, there's nothing. And there's kind of like a little weird foggish look in the sky when it's raining in the jungle, but, or not jungle, but desert, but besides that, it doesn't rain. But again, if you go to any other biome, it rains. When winter biomes, it snows. Here, on the other hand, when you go to a different biome, the whole entire atmosphere changes. So right here, we're in a regular, what looks to be just the water, like a lake or something. And the sky's all nice, you look at the sun, but then you go into the red clay biome, everything turns red. It's pretty amazing in my opinion. Like, I love the feeling, it feels like you're actually in whatever red clay. You know, I guess I could fit this into maybe the canyon, the Grand Canyon type of environment that we have, the desert type of environments that we have in the Americas, in the South. Like, I'm thinking New Mexico. type of land. I know a lot of you guys may not know where that is, but it feels like this type of biome would fit that perfectly, just with the sun being like nice and bright and then everything being reddish. I don't know, but I love this, and I want to see something like this implemented into Minecraft. Now, I know a lot of you guys are saying this should only stick as a mod. I'm not saying take the mod and straight up add it into Minecraft, and of course with the new mod API, mods will work just fine in Minecraft, but what I'm saying is take the genius idea or the implementation that they have on a whole entire atmosphere change to biomes, because honestly I think that the jungles in Minecraft right now should have a whole entire different atmosphere, a little more of a jungle atmosphere, and maybe they should have different types of storms, more tropical storms, and maybe of course they should have added birds so you could have bird sounds, but something like that would just be amazing. Just like winter biomes should have a whole, well actually they kind of do, but a whole entire winter aspect, which when I'm, if you guys stay tuned, I will be making a video showing off the winter biomes. I'm going to be showing both the glaciers and of course the winter forest, which is like a frosted forest, and it is amazing. So tune in for that, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I don't want to make this video too long for you guys, but there are a ton more biomes to show and more community speaks for you guys to get a chance to both win stuff and of course put your thoughts out there, and your comments could be in the next video. So again, leave your comments in this video, guys, and yeah, I will be looking through them. I will be adding a couple of them into the next video and all that awesome stuff. So thank you for that. And you know what, I doubt this would ever happen, but let's try to make this a challenge. If you guys could get 400 likes in this video, it's not gonna happen, but if that was to happen, I will make a special giveaway video where I give away 5 things to you guys. 5 things. I'm also going to make the video a cool little edit and it'll be fun. But that's only if this video gets 400 likes, which I know it's not going to happen. But if it does, then that is your prize for everyone. So yeah, and I'm also working on doing something that maybe I could buy like a coupon, or I'm trying to think of something I could do where everyone is a winner, because I always wanted to do that. Maybe a giveaway where I spend like $1,000 on a special game code or something like that, where everyone can just type a code in, all of my viewers can type it in, and they're all winners. And by winners, I mean that's like my prize to you guys. So I'm gonna try to do something like that, because I mean, in my opinion, I think something like that is worth it. I'd rather pay like $1,000 for a big prize that everyone can enjoy than having to pay like $30-$50 every winner that gets something. And I say $30-$50 because I think Minecraft's like $30, and then some of you guys pick like a hoodie or something. And like I said, I will give you guys whatever you want from the Minecraft junk store, except for the Minecraft Legos, because that is sold out. But besides that, anything. So thank you guys for watching, thank you for all your support, and thank you for your comments and everything. So again, if you guys want to join our website, I didn't mention this, but you guys can hit the annotation in the top left that will take you to our website, and the IPs to our server are in the top banner, and they are free to join. Now we're waiting for 1.4.7 to come out so we can update to it without all the bugs and glitches that's currently happening in 1.4.6. So if you're watching in the future, just go ahead and join. If it's down for you, then just wait, it's being updated. But yeah. That's basically it. Hope y'all enjoyed, and I will talk to you later. Remember, new videos every single day. Thank you for watching, and Happy New Year's. Bye.